Good morning and welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. September is the month for the National Catechetical, the teachers and the creation. Today we have the catechist and the rite of acceptance for the candidates who have enrolled themselves to complete their Christian initiation through the sacrament of Holy Eucharist and Confirmation. Today, we also celebrate Catechist Day and Grandparents Day. The Church joyfully welcomes today all these children who are already one with us by baptism. This is an online service, and the candidates along with their parents will partake in this Eucharistic celebration from home. The candidates and their parents will be called out by their name and will be instructed about their responses. As we celebrate this Eucharist, let us pray for these children in a special way, that they may be strengthened in faith, as well as pray for our catechist, that through this Holy Spirit, they may receive the grace to serve our church.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 489. Hymn number 489, kindly rise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, this Mass, in a special way, is offered for the intentions of our parishioners, and also for the children who are going to be accepted in the rite of acceptance, those who are doing their going to get their first Holy Communion this year, and also those who are preparing themselves for confirmation, and they will get confirmation at the end of this year. This is an online service. As we are celebrating this Eucharist, I pray in a special way for the first Holy Communion children, and also for the confirmation children and their parents, so that God may bless them and bless them very well to prepare themselves for this important event which is coming into their life. My dear parents, as you are at home and participating in this Eucharist, make sure that you pray for your own children as well.
Lord, have mercy, we have sinned. Lord, have mercy, we have sinned. Christ, have mercy, we have sinned. Christ, have mercy, we have sinned. Lord, we know we've gone the wrong. Lord, we know not
see we are sinners. Lord, have mercy, we have sinned.
Dear parents, when your children were infants, you brought them to be baptized and to initiate them into the family of the church community. Now you have asked that your children be prepared for yet another sacrament of initiation, the Holy Eucharist, the first Holy Communion. Do you sincerely desire this?
We do.
Are you willing to do your part in preparing your children for the sacrament of Holy Eucharist?
We are.
These boys and girls have set out on the road to be initiated further in our Christian community. They will need the support of our faith and love. Are you, their families and friends, ready to give them that help?
We are.
Following are the list of communicants who are preparing themselves to receive the first Holy Communion. Alicia D'Souza, Astel Fernandez, Edwin Rodericks, Ethan Montero, Ethan Khandekar, Ivan Gonsalves, Hazel Parmar, Janice Nazareth, Jaden D'Souza, Joanna Francis, Jonic Suarez, Karen Sequeira, Kiara Patel, Nihar Shete, Skylar Gonsalves, Urella Corda, Zion D'Souza. Now the celebrant will ask the communicants collectively to express their intentions by means of the questions below.
What do you want from the parish community?
To prepare myself for First Holy Communion.
Why do you want to receive Holy Eucharist?
I have been baptized in Christ and now I want to come to his table.
What do you gain by coming to his table?
The love and power of Jesus and eternal life.
My dear parents, when your children were infants, you brought them to be baptized and to initiate them into the family of the church community. A few years ago, you prepared them for Holy Eucharist. Now, you have asked that your children be prepared for yet another sacrament of initiation, the confirmation. Do you sincerely desire this?
We do.
Are you willing to do your part in preparing your children for the sacrament of confirmation?
We are.
These boys and girls have set out on the road to be initiated further into our Christian community. They will need the support of our faith and love. Are you, my dear parents, my dear families and friends, ready to give them that help?
We are.
Following are the list of confirmants who are preparing themselves to receive the sacrament of confirmation. Abigail Fernandez, Abigail Mascarenhas, Aquila Menezes, Alston Mesquita, Anushka Pinero, Aryan Figger, Asher Fernandez, Austin Lobo, Deanne Xavier, Giovanni Andrew, Jackie Mahida, Joshua Sequeira, Keith Sequeira, Grisel Narona, Levin Gonsalves, Lorraine Hendricks, Martin Fernandez, Nathan Sequeira, Nicole Rodericks, Ricky D'Souza, Ria D'Souza, Rylan Rodericks, Salome Malkut, Sarah Kadu, Sean DeMello, Sean Cardoso, Susan D'Souza, Taksh Bhosle, Varun Rao, Vinay End, Wilson Rodericks, Vinola Fernandez. Now, the celebrant will ask the confirmants collectively to express their intentions by means of questions below.
What do you want from the parish community?
To prepare myself for confirmation.
Why do you want to receive confirmation?
I have been baptized in Christ and now I want to complete my Christian initiation.
What do you gain from coming to be confirmed?
The love and power of the Holy Spirit to make me a courageous witness of Jesus.
My dear children of the First Holy Communion and my dear youngsters of the rite of confirmation, I do pray for both of you, both the groups, as you are standing with your parents in your respective homes, prayerfully attending this Eucharistic celebration. Let us now sign the candidates with the cross. Dear candidates for the First Holy Communion and confirmation, Christ has called you to be his friends. Always remember him to be faithful to him. Therefore, I mark your forehead with the sign of the cross. It is the sign of Christians. Let it remind you always of Christ and how much he loves you and wants to empower you with his Holy Spirit. Since we are not present in front of each other, I invite the parents to mark their children with the sign of the cross. Thank you, my dear parents, and thank you, my dear children. Let us now sing the Gloria.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right.
alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and Ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Siraj. Resentment and anger, these are foul things, and both are found with the sinners. He who exacts vengeance will experience the vengeance of the Lord. Who keeps strict account of sin, forgive your neighbor the hurt he does you, and when you pray, your sins will be forgiven. If a man nurses anger against another, can he then demand compassion from the Lord? Showing no pity for a man like himself, can he then plead for his own sins? Mere creatures of flesh, he cherishes resentment. Who will forgive him his sins? Remember the last thing and stop hating. Remember dissolution and death, and live by the commandments. Remember the commandments, and do not bear your neighbor's ill will. Remember the covenant of the Most High, and overlook the offense. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly join us for the responsorial psalm.
Compassion and love, slow to anger and rich in mercy.
Please repeat.
The Lord is compassion and love, slow to anger and rich in mercy. May my soul give thanks to the Lord, all my being bless his name, for he fills my life with good things. I will never forget all his blessings. The Lord is compassion and love, slow to anger and rich in mercy. He forgives us all of our sins, and he heals us of our ills. He redeems our life from the grave, and he crowns us with love and compassion. The Lord is compassion and love, slow to anger and rich in mercy. know his anger will not endure, but his love will last all time. And all those who honor the Lord know his goodness will span generations. The Lord is compassion and love, slow to anger and rich in mercy.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The life and death of each of us has its influence on others. If we live for the Lord. And if we die for the Lord. So that, alive or dead, we belong to the Lord. This explains why Christ both died and came to life. It was so that he might be the Lord both of the dead and of the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 592. Hymn number 592. Kindly rise.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. I call you friends as the Lord. You are my disciples. I make known to you all I've learned from my Father. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia,
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Peter went up to Jesus and said, Lord, how often must I forgive my brother if he wrongs me? As often as seven times? Jesus answered, Not seven, I tell you, but 70 times 7. And so the kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who decided to settle his accounts with his servants. When the reckoning began, they brought him a man who owed 10,000 talents, but he had no means of paying. So his master gave orders that he should be sold together with his wife and children and all his possessions to meet the debt. At this, the servant threw himself down at the master's feet. Give me time, he said, and I will pay the whole sum. And the servant's master felt so sorry for him that he let him go and cancelled the debt. Now as this servant went out, he happened to meet a fellow servant who owed him 100 denarii. And he seized him by the throat and began to throttle him. "Pay what you owe me," he said. His fellow servant fell at his feet and implored him, saying, "Give me time and I will pay you." But the other would not agree. On the contrary, he had him thrown into prison till he should pay the debt. His fellow servants were deeply distressed when they saw what had happened, and they went to their master and reported the whole affair to him. Then the master sent for him. "You wicked servant," he said, "I cancelled all that debt of yours when you appealed to me. Were you not bound then to have pity on your fellow servant, just as I had pity on you?" And in his anger, the master handed him over to the torturers till he should pay all the debt. And that is how my heavenly Father will do with you, unless you each forgive your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, today, as we are praying for all our First Holy Communion children and all the confirmation children, today the message is very wonderful. We have to learn to forgive. If you forgive one another, then God also can forgive you without even asking a question. He just asks us that we should forgive one another. The first reading taken from the book of Sirach, it says, "Forgive your neighbor and the hurt he has done for you." This is how he says. Otherwise, if we don't forgive one another, the first reading is telling us resentment and anger will come. And if we have vengeance in our hearts, how can we ask the Lord to forgive our sins when we are full of hatred, resentment and anger? Therefore, in the first reading from the book of Sirach, the author is asking us that we learn to forgive one another. The second reading taken from the book of Romans, "Alive or dead, we are for the Lord. If you are alive and you live, it is for the Lord. And if you die, it is also for the Lord." And St. Paul, so many places, he says beautifully, even in the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians, he said, "For me to live is Christ and to die is gain, because when I am alive, I am with Christ. When I die, I am one with Christ once again. And therefore, for me, it's not a problem that whether I am alive or dead." This is what St. Paul is telling us. And the third reading taken from the Gospel of Matthew is still very excellent. Peter asks one question: "How many times I must forgive my brother if he does wrong?" And the Lord beautifully says, not 7 times as Peter says, but 70 times 7. And this is how the Lord is asking us. He is asking us to forgive always. Forgive always. That reading, the first man, he received the forgiveness from his master. All his debts are forgiven. But when he goes to the second person, his fellow servant, he doesn't forgive him. It is because he has not experienced the forgiveness. He thinks the master has to forgive, and that forgiveness is not experienced by the first fellow. And he puts the other man into prison. And when his fellow servants listen and see all this, they feel very sad. They are distressed. That's what the word is used. Because How this fellow can not forgive his fellow servant for 1,000 denarii, and he wants they go and report it, and the master puts him into prison. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, prayer helps us so that we experience the forgiveness of the Lord. As in the prodigal son in St. Luke chapter 15, it is said that the forgiveness is given by the father. The prodigal son returns back and the father is waiting with open hands to embrace him and to forgive him without any questions, without any doubt. My son was dead, he is alive, he was lost and he has found me, and that's it, my love expression for him. We will have festivities. The elder son remaining with him, he has not experienced the forgiving love and the compassionate love of the father, and therefore resentment, anger. And then the father explains and he comes back with the beautiful embrace with the father and also the elder son. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, we need to learn to forgive. It may sound strange to speak about forgiveness as a discipline. Make yourself one principle in life very clear. At every given moment and in every circumstance, I will forgive. It's a choice which I have to make. It is also a grace from God, but it's a choice. My heart should be ready to forgive. Accept that other person as he or she is. Forgiveness is a great spiritual weapon against the evil one. The evil one will control us with unforgiveness, and therefore we remain victims of anger, resentment. The power of darkness can continue to divide us and tempt us with endless power games. But then when we forgive, all these things goes away. We also are in the loving embrace of God. The first thing to forgive is, my dear brothers and sisters and my dear children who are listening to me today, you forgive in the name of God. In the name of God, we must forgive. On the cross, Jesus says, Father, forgive them for they know not what they are doing. Please accept my forgiveness on your behalf and forgive all of them. Don't hold this sin against them. This is what we reach when we forgive in the name of God. This is what Jesus is asking us to do. Second, my dear parishioners and my dear parents, forgive people for not being God. All the people are not being God. You might have reached a high status in your spiritual life. The other has not reached, and therefore his faults and failures, accept it, that he is not God. He is not like you. I'm not saying as me, but he is not like you, not to sin. He is sinning. He is hurting you. Therefore forgive, because that person is not being God. Third, take one step towards forgiveness. You will see how beautiful your life will be. Every night you will go to sleep very peacefully if you have forgiven. When the sun sets, you also have forgiven every person who has hurted you during that day. And you sleep peacefully. You get a good night rest. And you are happy to tell Jesus, I have forgiven all. Receive my forgiveness and also forgive me. The next fourth point, praying for your enemies. Pray for our enemies. Have you ever prayed for our enemies so that they may accept forgiveness and they learn to forgive? It has not happened. Let's learn to pray for our enemies. The fifth, there are two qualities in forgiveness. Listen carefully to this. If I tell someone, I am forgiving you, that person will question and me, Father Solomon, what wrong I have done against you that you are forgiving me? This is the answer of all those people. They say, we have not done wrong, why you have to forgive? To accept forgiveness also is very difficult. To give forgiveness, it rather easy. So two qualities, one to receive forgiveness and one to give forgiveness to another person. And I'm sure you will see your life will be in the loving embrace of God. That's why my sixth point is the embrace of a forgiving God. Have you gone for confession and experienced such tremendous change within you that you have felt the forgiving embrace of our Lord Jesus Christ, His love, His compassion, and with that, you know that this experience you need to give towards all and also you need to receive every time. This is what it is. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, let us pray. Prayer helps to forgive and also to receive forgiveness. Today, as we are into this Sunday, let's pray for one another. God gives us the grace to forgive. Also remember, I said that forgiveness should be part and parcel of my life as a discipline. I decide to forgive and I forgive with God's grace and experience of His loving embrace in my life. I wish you a beautiful Sunday and also pray this gift of forgiveness becomes ours. Let's forgive one another so that no one rules us except the Lord Jesus. May God bless all of us. The profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The prayer of the faithful. We are fully aware of our sinfulness and of our duty we have to forgive our offenders. Let us then ask the grace to be as merciful and compassionate as God is.
Let our response be, Merciful Lord, hear us.
Merciful Lord, hear us.
For the universal and our local church, may she be a clear sign, an instrument of God's merciful love for all human beings. Let us pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear us.
For our Holy Father and all our spiritual leaders, may they continue to inspire us with their magnanimity towards those who offend them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear us.
For our civil leaders and other people in authority, may they set a good example in seeking reconciliation and collaboration with political opponents for the greater good of our country. Let us pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear us.
For the different social classes, May they learn to be fair to one another and work together for the promotion of social justice and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear us.
For all teachers, and especially our catechists, may Jesus, the divine teacher catechist, be their constant inspiration as they give their best in forming our children and youth as loving Christians and upright citizens. Let us pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear us.
For all our grandparents, both those who are still living and those who have gone to their eternal rest, may the Lord reward them abundantly for the love they have lavished upon us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear us.
For creation, Lord, you brought all things into existence from nothing and inscribed in each being from the beginning the goal which it was to accomplish. Pour out your blessing on the whole of creation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear us.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear us.
Let us pray. Lord God, help us to imitate your Son Jesus Christ, who forgave even those who crucified him. Grant us the grace to become the signs and instruments of your forgiving love, and thereby promote the peace of the kingdom, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 125. Hymn number 125.
Comes the time we bring to you just a little bread and wine, my Lord. All we say and all we do, just a little bread and wine. Morning time and time for prayer, just a little bread and wine, my Lord. Bread we take, we break and share, just a little bread and wine. Food and drink, and you, O Christ, just a little bread and wine, my Lord. To the Father, the sacrifice, just a little bread and wine.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servant's offering, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Holy Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal Mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 588, hymn number 588.
Holy, 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 God of might and God of power, glory fills all earth and heaven, sing Hosanna to the Lord. Blessed is the one who comes in glory from the Lord. Raise your voices, sing his praises, sing Hosanna to the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 176. Hymn number 176.
This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. Charity is kind, feels no envy. Charity bears up to the end. Charity is meek, seeking not its own. Charity has faith to the end. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. Love one another as I have loved you. Love one another as I have loved you.
The anima Christi, soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from Christ's side, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from thee. From the malicious enemy, defend me. In the hour of my death, call me and bid me come unto thee, that I may praise thee with thy saints and with thy angels forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Let us thank Jesus for being so good and blessing us during this period of lockdown. Today, in a special way, he has blessed our First Holy Communion children and also our confirmation children. He has blessed their parents and all of you, those who are listening, those who are viewing this Mass. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that it affects and not our own desires may always prevail in us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly take your hymn books to hymn number 293. Hymn number 293.
This world you have made is a beautiful place. It tells the power of your love. We rejoice in the beauty of your world, from the seas to the heavens above. The morning whispers of purity, the evening of your peace. The thunder booms your exuberance, in the awesome power you release. This world you have made is a beautiful place. It tells the power of your love. We rejoice in the beauty of your word, from the seas to the heavens above. From the seas to the heavens above.